Hey, what's going on, guys? Hanging out with my good buddy Fred Grunwald. He's got in his hand a very magnificent snapping turtle. This is the alligator snapper, and right here I have myself a little common snapper. So today, it's all about snapping turtles. We're gonna have a pretty good time discussing the differences. There are two things I've loved most in this life, bikes and reptiles. Now I crisscross the globe learning about all kinds of incredible animals. Sometimes I know what I'm doing. Other times, I'm in over my head. But one thing's for certain, we'll come away a whole lot smarter after every adventure. This is Kamp Kenan. All right, so as a boy growing up in Long Island, New York, these were some of the first turtles I ever had. I have a soft spot for these guys, and these are the common snapper. We have a common snapper here, right, Fred?
Right, this is common.
And this is a true Florida snapping turtle. And you can tell, guys, if you get close and you look at the neck, and this is a true snapper disposition, by the way. But if you look at the neck, there's really a lot of tubercles and projections on the neck, whereas the common snapper does not have those. So that's one way to really know. If you get close to them, you can kind of see the neck has all those. And man, snapping turtles have extremely long necks, a reduced plastron, as you can see here, and then an extremely long tail. That's why these guys have developed these powerful jaws to protect themselves. They really can't retract into their shell because look, all this fleshy part is left exposed. And there's his male parts coming out right now, right there. You can see sometimes when they get upset, they'll avert their penis and that'll also emit some musk. So these guys are ambush predators. They have that reduced plastron on the bottom, but the top shell is extremely effective when you're walking in the water. Now, the cool thing about snappers, you get them out of the water, Fred, what do they want to do to you?
They want to bite.
Yeah, exactly. But in the water, I've actually stepped on snapping turtles and they have not bit me at all. So they feel very at home in the water, which is great. These guys are almost entirely aquatic. You'll only see females coming out of the water onto land to lay their eggs. And the only time males come out is if their ponds have dried up. You gotta be quick with snapping turtles. And these are just little ones. So what do you say, you go ahead, I'll hold this one. Why don't you go ahead and dig on in there, we'll pull out another type of snapping turtle that you'll find here in North America. And by the way, the snapping turtle goes from Maine all the way down throughout the southeast United States into the central states, all the way to Colorado and then south into northern South America. Many different subspecies of the snapping turtle, and the genus is called Chelydra, and that means snake-like swamp thing, because look at that head. It's certainly attached to a very snake-like neck.
I know he's in here.
Oh yeah, just keep your fingers safe there, buddy. Make sure you got the right end, dude.
Okay.
Ah, there you go. Now that's the true swamp thing right there, man. This is the alligator snapping turtle. And so many people that don't really know reptiles always call the regular snapping turtle an alligator snapping turtle. It must frustrate you.
That happens every single time somebody calls for a snapper. I've got an alligator snapper, and well, 100% of the time down here, it's
yeah,
a common.
Yeah, it's a regular old common or Florida snapping turtle. So let's look at some of the differences here, man. They definitely have the reduced plastron, just like these guys. They have the long tail, but the big main difference is the head. Look at the size of the head on the alligator snapping turtle. That is a massive set of jaws that you do not want to mess with. So also, attached to the head is a shorter neck. And you can actually pick this guy up, show him, there you go. You can actually pick the gator snappers up by holding onto the carapace. You never want to try that with a regular common snapper because they can actually come back here if they really were interested, which I think he might do. He's on to me. He's on to me, man. And I don't even want to get bit by this little maniac. But anyway, you always want to grab a common snapping turtle up by the rear of their carapace. So that's some of the differences right there. Now I'm going to put these guys down and we're going to focus a little bit on the alley snapper. I'm going to hand these over. My buddy Kyle, thanks brother. Mm-hmm. All right, so what's really exciting about these animals, Fred, man, is that jaw. I mean, these guys are ambush predators. All they do is sit around and wait, and they wait with their mouths open. They look like the bottom of the oxbow or lake or river, whatever body of water, slow moving body of water that they're in. So what I want you to focus on now is probably the most famous thing about the alligator snapper, and that is its lure-like, worm-like tongue right there, you can kind of see that tongue. Now, if I were to just touch, that would make it would trigger a response from his jaws. You see that? And there's all these old wives' tales that they can break a broom handle in half. Not true. They do have powerful jaws, but it's pretty hard to break a broom handle in half. Yeah, they I've can, however. You've never seen
never
that.
Seen it happen. Even with the big ones.
Fred, you wouldn't be insulted by me saying you're one of the old timers, right?
Yeah.
Been around. Fred's been around. He's seen a lot. But we've never seen an alligator snapper break a broom handle in half.
Not yet.
But if you're a little fish, this will definitely do it. Hey, let's stop messing around with these little guys and see if we can show the folks at home what you really have as far as alligator snappers. My goodness. Look.
Actually, that's a Florida.
This is a Florida?
And it's probably one of the largest. It is by far the largest I've seen.
So look at this, guys. This is a full-grown Florida snapping turtle. So you can see how big they are, but yet, here's the difference. See how smooth that carapace is? Doesn't have the gnarls like the alligator snapper. And if this guy wanted, he could get my hat from here. So let's put him down, and we'll show you what a full-size alligator snapping turtle looks like. So in order to show you the grand finale, folks, we have to come in here and fish for him, our buddy. And what you may not realize is that there's a saltwater crocodile on the other side of this pond, just letting us do our thing. Ah, here we go. You got it, Fred. I love Fred's house. That's nice. Oh my God, careful, buddy.
Now this one is missing his beak.
Yep. Now how about
that big alligator down there? That's why that alligator's name is Snaggletooth. When that alligator was a baby, this guy bit a chunk out of his jaw. That's why that gator looks like that.
Wow.
And then later in life, that gator took his beak off.
So a little payback. So it doesn't look like this guy's having any problems being fed, but folks, this is a full-grown alligator snapper, and believe it or not, they can get bigger. Fred, you actually had one that was a tad bit bigger, but unfortunately, time ran out on that guy. He passed away. He was a very old animal. How long have you had these animals?
I've had these for nearly 50 years. And they were almost the size when I got them. And some of these old jars, I mean, some people say they're musket ball holes, or who knows what the real story is, but these are definitely some old turtles. I would guess that they're probably around the 100-year mark.
Right.
But in reality, there's no true way to tell.
Right.
So it's all just guesstimating, but we do know that they grow very, very old. And they do get actually twice the size, maybe even a little bit bigger. They're definitely one of the largest freshwater turtles in the world. Not the largest, but in the U.S. they are.
Yeah, and they are marvelous animals, though. So they are true dinosaurs. So, folks, even if he doesn't have a beak, I don't want to get bit by that guy. Thank you very much for the exciting finale. Well, I'll tell you what, folks. We learned a little bit about the alligator snapper, the common snapper. So next time someone says that a common snapper is an alligator snapper, you make sure and show them this video. Don't forget to subscribe, click that link. Thanks again, visit us at campkenan.com, Instagram. You might even see more pictures of, what's his name?
Snappy.
I see more pictures of Snappy. See you next Tuesday, guys. Later.